currently in class, about to hit 60,000 words. I'm at 559,999. Ready? Ready? 60,000 is falls. Got my best writing buddy over here.
So freaking proud of you.
I've been writing buddies since sixth grade. Yes, my hero. Anyway, I have to put my mask on back now. Hello, it is future Abby here to welcome you to this video and tell you that I didn't film an intro clip for this video. I did, but it's lost somewhere in the mess of time and camera rolls and recently deleted, so I'm just gonna make a new one. So this vlog is me trying to finish my draft before my graduation, which was on May 28th. I started this video like 10 days before. I don't know, I'll say somewhere in the video, but this is me just going full power. Power to the finish is what I refer to it as. Just powering to the finish of this draft and just doing all the work and sprinting to the end. So, hope you enjoy. Welcome to the video, and I will see you in the next clip. Happy day two of Power to the Finish writing vlogs. It's 11:30 on Thursday. I don't know what day it is because I honestly don't know. I have had a very, today's been one of those days. I woke up, I was gonna write, and then I found out that I didn't get the job that I interviewed for, and I was kind of sad. So I took my nutrition final instead. I did really good on it. So it's been a very, it's been a day full of positives and negatives. So right now, my goal is to go to Joann's and get some stuff, get some things to decorate my grad cap. I'm trying to learn how to talk slower. So that's, if I repeat myself, that's why, because I'm trying to learn how to talk at a normal human speed. So I'm gonna go to Joann's with my grandma and we are gonna get some stuff to decorate my grad cap. And yeah, that's the goal right now. I was thinking about maybe later today going and taking like a blanket to the park and riding outside. I don't know if I'll do that, but it definitely is something that I would like to do at some point. So that's not the goal right now. I know I never write, but I am going to write after I do this grad cap thing, because then I won't be able to like think about it and I won't have to worry about it anymore. So yes, that's the plan for today. We'll see how it goes. Hello, it's a lovely afternoon here in Mormonville, Utah. It's very hot. It's only May and I'm already like sweating and hating the hot, so I don't know how I'll survive the summer. But I didn't film a clip yesterday because I did an experiment where I told myself I left my phone in my room all day and wrote downstairs without my phone near me, and it worked really well. I wrote like 2,000 words yesterday, which isn't as much as I would have liked to, because I did get distracted by SNL clip compilations on YouTube. Those are like the devil. So I did get a little bit distracted, but I did get a lot of work done and I plan to do the same today. So I left my phone upstairs and I wrote about 1,000 words, probably like 900 something this morning. Did I get distracted by SNL? Yes, I did again, but it's only one. I'm gonna go and run some errands. I have to get stuff for my grad cap because I didn't do that a couple days ago. I'm gonna go get some stuff to hang up my friend's graduation announcements on my wall. And I'm gonna go help my grandma with some stuff, but then we're just gonna write. And I think that eliminating my phone from my writing process has been a very helpful thing. But yeah, I gotta go now. Gotta turn up the AC because I am about to die of heat. Hello buddies, it's Sunday. You're at a very weird angle right now, so if you can like hear my engine or like if you fall over, I can't help it. I've never like, you're set up on a smart water bottle and it's very fragile. But anyway, it's Sunday and I haven't been filming updates like in between the days, except when I'm in my car, because I have been doing my best to not have my phone anywhere near me when I write, and it's been going really well. Fridays before Saturday. On Friday, I wrote about 2,100 words, and yesterday I wrote 2,300 words, so that's very good. Today I'm starting earlier. It's a Sunday, so I don't have any plans. Yesterday I had a bunch of stuff I needed to do, but today I have no plans. I'm blocking myself from Twitter on my laptop because besides my phone, that's my one big distraction, so I'm blocking Twitter, like I'm blacklisting it, not getting on, and then I'm just gonna try and write as much as I can. My goal is 6,000 words today. Is that a lot? Yes. But I'll have to give, I'll give you a little tour of my outside writing space because it's just 10 out of 10 amazing. And yeah, I'm gonna go get a frap. I used to call them frappes because I feel like that sounded more like real and professional. I don't know. But I'm gonna go get a frap and a croissant for breakfast at the only coffee shop in town, and then I'm gonna go to my grandparents and just write all day because I love writing outside. I love just like that atmosphere. So yes, that's the plan, that's the schedule. and we will see how it goes. Will I write 6,000 words today? We can only hope. Okay, this is a tour of my little writing zone. So, here we go. So we have this little spinning thing, and then over here we have my bird swing and my frap. It's very comfy, and hummingbird feeder, and then some plants. And these lilacs are very fragrant. They're my neighbors, but they're really nice. But yes, this is my little writing zone. Also, my neighbors have a cat that comes to visit. My grandma doesn't like when he comes over because she doesn't like cats, but he hops over the fence and watches me write, and he's my friend. So 10 out of 10 would recommend. The friend has come to join and take a nap on the tires. Big stretch. Big stretch. Hi, friend. Hello, gang. Happy Monday. There are 8 days until my deadline, and I'm doing actually really well. I haven't written yet today because I've been at school and stuff, but yesterday I wrote 4,000 words, which was very nice, very exciting, very nice to just start writing. I'm in a very, like, fresh part of the story. I think I know this part of the story the best, so I'm feeling very confident about starting it, but currently I'm at 69,282 words. I wrote 279 of those words today in class, but yeah, I have a lot of writing to do today if I want to catch up, but yesterday was an awesome writing day, and just makes me feel really good that, like, I'm starting to make forward progress because I felt like I was just going to be stagnant forever. Hello, welcome to Bad Lighting with me. I am about to write my 70,000th word. That word is of, and here we go. Hit 70,000 words. Feeling good about it. It's 11:34. I'm so tired. I'm like, you can see the moisturizer on my face. I'm feeling tired. I'm kind of dead, but 70,000 words. We're doing well. I have started to realize that I've realized that a lot of my writing, like those scenes I write, are just filler that doesn't need to be there. So I just like deleted a whole chapter because it's just filler. I didn't finish it because I felt like I was forcing myself, and I was like, why am I forcing myself to finish this, you know? I asked myself, instead of just like powering through it, I was like, okay, like, what's the problem here? And the problem here is that that doesn't need to be in the story. So it was nice to like realize that I could just take it out. And I've been realizing that a lot recently. So writing what's important now, and that's all that matters. Also, 70,000 words. That's very exciting. I'm gonna sleep now. I'm so tired. Hello, happy May 19th. I know the day. It's Wednesday. It's Wednesday. So I wrote a lot of words last night. I wrote 1,000 words at midnight, so I was being sarcastic about the lot of words. I plan to go to my grandparents' house today. They're not home, but I can sneak into their backyard and sit in my little writing zone. So that's the plan today. I have to go to the post office, get some stuff to decorate my grad cap, but all in all, I'm feeling pretty good today. I've also got my shoulders out. If you live in Utah or you're a Mormon, you know that this is like a big thing when you leave the church. It's very taboo to show your shoulders. It's very immodest. So I'm looking pretty immodest today, but my fit is fire. I got like these like bell-bottom pants on. Oh, I look good today. So I'm kind of feeling like a god amongst men, but I do need to like do a lot of writing today. So gonna go run my errands, go to my grandparents' house, sneak in the backyard, and do some writing. Okay, gang, it's 11:30. We have a frap and a croissant. And we have my laptop, and we are just ready to go. So let's start writing. Let's see how much gets done today. Hopefully a lot, but yeah, that's the tea for today. I'm gonna watch Cody Ko's new video while I eat my breakfast, and then we're gonna get to writing. If you wanna know how good I am at getting gifts, this is what I got my sister for her birthday. Yeah, so I'm obviously awesome because I got her all 3 volumes of Heartstopper that are out in the US. My favorite series that I think she'll enjoy. It's even the colored one, so we're winning. And then I got her, I wrote her a letter, so that counts. I got her a custom planner because I like planners and I like Heartstopper, so I just got her what I would like because I'm awesome at giving gifts and I just get people what I want and then hope they like it. So that's my gift giving fact. I've been at my grandparents. I wrote about 1,000 words, about 72,000 words now. And yeah, I'm gonna go run some errands and drop books all over. I'm gonna go run some errands and then come back and do some more writing. Hello, gang. My grad cap is looking cool as hell, but I'm one end short, so I have to go see if they have the stickers I need at Walmart because I got them at Joann's. I got all of them, so hopefully they have the stickers I need at Joann's, or else at Walmart or else we're gonna be up a creek because I need another N.
I just thought I should show you my graduation cap. Also, SNL in the background, if you can hear that, I'm sorry. Hello, it's Friday. I had a math test I was supposed to take today and a therapy appointment, and I canceled both of them, and I slept all day. So it's 4 in the afternoon, and I'm just, like, getting up and starting to be alive. So, currently I am writing. Not really, I'm reading what I wrote. I haven't written a single word today, but I have the intention to write, so that's all that counts. I'm making myself frozen pizza, because that's all we have in our house. So, yeah. Just trying to survive, trying to get some stuff done. Feeling pretty terrible today, but that's okay. I'm heading to the city tomorrow for a lantern festival, and I would like to write in the car, if that's possible, but who knows? Who knows what anything is anymore? I just need to finish this freaking draft. Hello, it is nearly 7. I've written maybe like a paragraph all day. I'm doing awesome, but yeah. I am doing something that I told myself, I'm sweating a bug, but I'm gonna go get a lemonade. I've been off lemonade for a while, but I really need like the sugar today. So I put on some jeans instead of just wearing sweatpants all day. So I'm gonna go check the mail, leave the house at 7 at night, and see if that makes me feel any more alive than I feel now, because I kind of feel like a dead woman walking, but I gotta finish this draft. I gotta finish this draft. I have like 4 days left to finish it, and I'm nowhere close. And I just realized how little time 4 days is and how soon I wanna be finished, so all-nighter. Am I pulling an all-nighter tonight? We'll see. Hello, gang. It is the 22nd, 3 days before my deadline. And if you want to know how my day is going today, I hate driving in the car. That's just a fun fact about me. I really struggle with it. It's just like sensory hell for me. So I hate driving in the car. But we had this lantern festival we were going to go to out in the city tonight. So we drove 4 hours and I really powered through it. I really worked hard to like survive this car ride so I could have a fun night at this lantern festival. And I was really anxious for it, but I was really excited to go. So we get out to the city, and after 4 hours of being in the car, me being anxious, and the festival gets canceled. So we drive 4 hours back. I'm even more anxious. And it was kind of hell all day. But now I'm home, and I'm ready to write. I wrote, like, I fit 75,000 words. And I think that if I really kick it into gear, I can finish in the next 3 days. I just need to actually do the work instead of procrastinate. So I wasted a whole day today in the car, not writing, because I can't write and drive. It makes me feel nauseous. But yeah, there's a lot of work to do, and if I would just hunker down and do it, we'd be in shape. We'd be in business, but I need to actually do the work. Hello, gang. We have 2 days left, and there's still so much to do, and it is very intimidating. Anyway, it's almost 10. I'm going to get breakfast. My mom wants a coffee. I'm going to go get her coffee. And if you want to talk about this outfit, yes, I know it's horrendous, but it is freezing in Utah today. So we added a sweater until it warms up. But anyway, I don't know how I'm going to do this. I don't know how it's going to happen. I'm going to finish this book in the next 2 days, but I'm going to do it. I'm manifesting that I'm going to do it. I will not, if it means I don't sleep for the next 2 days, then that's what it means. But I'm going to finish this draft. And I'm not gonna watch any more Modern Family, because I started that show a couple days ago, and last night instead of writing, I was like, I'm just gonna watch one episode, then I'll write. And then I watched like half of a season. So yes, stop getting distracted and just, I need to just write. Why can't I just write? I think about writing all the time and I just never do it because I'm lazy, but yeah. Anyway, I gotta stop talking, I'm procrastinating. I gotta go run my errands and then get to writing. Also in terms of just life, this is the state of my room at the moment. Very snazzy. You can obviously tell I've been so productive recently. I put my hair up and procrastination levels have reached 100 because I cleaned my room and my closet and I vacuumed and I started laundry. So, writing's obviously going really well, but now I don't have anybody else to distract myself unless I want to clean the entire downstairs, which I might need to procrastinate, but right now, I am here
and I'm going to write if it kills me. So that's, we're finally to, we're past the procrastination part of the day and we're to the writing part, I hope.
Don't we get to be happy, Kathy? At some point down the line, don't we get to relax without some new tourist to push me yet further from you? And if I'm cheering on your side, Kathy, why can't you support mine? Why do I have to feel I've committed some felony doing what I always swore I would do? I don't want you to hurt. Hey. I don't want you to sing. But don't make me wait till you do to be happy with you. Will you listen to me? No one can give you courage. No one can thicken your skin. I will not fail so you can be comfortable, Kathy. I will not lose because you can't win.
I'm so good at writing. I'm so productive. I'm serving egghead vibes right now, but my mom has just decided, I did clean the downstairs, by the way, but my mom has decided that her boyfriend's band has to have auditions at our house. For some reason, unbeknownst to me, they have to be at our house. So I am leaving. I'm going to my grandparents' house to go sit outside. I had my 4,000 word day when I sat outside of my grandparents' house. Hopefully that happens again, and my washer is very loud, but yeah, I'm not staying here for band practice. I'm leaving, so that's fun. I refuse to be here with all of her friends because I hate them. Never mind, my neighbor's bringing out her Pomeranian, so I'm gonna go see the Pomeranian because he's so cute. He's so cute, little smoky.
They're gonna practice a little bit in my house, so if it gets loud.
I just got to meet my neighbor's Pomeranian, and so my day is obviously just got a lot better. Hey homies, it's my last day of school. I just came home. I don't know, I'm feeling a lot of things right now. I'm kind of upset that there's these boys I eat lunch with every day, and I asked them to take a picture with me to put on my wall at college, and they said no, so that's kind of sad, but my deadline is today, but I might push it to tomorrow because I have a lot to do, but anyway, I'm going to go write right now and just feel all the things. I'm singing sad songs in my car right now. I've been singing If I Didn't Believe in You and, like, making myself teary, but I haven't gotten, like, weepy and sad about it yet, but I know that I will, so we're just going to roll with the punches for a while and try to finish this draft in the next 48 hours.
She called her friend silly and asked, "Sai's gonna get in, please." What's in, please? In, what, silly?
Ew! Welcome.
For real.
Hey, can you? It needs to stop beeping. How about I make this stop beeping?
Well, you put. I'm okay.
1 second. No, beep my vlog.
I have to. Mom's yelling at me.
Anyway, welcome to my vlog for the day. Today's the day I'm gonna finish my book. That kills me. I'm in a slough school because I actually don't have school today. It's a senior trip, and I'm not going on a senior trip, so I'm going to finish my book. I don't care if it kills me, but that's what we're doing today. Jazz, how do you feel? Do you think I can do it?
Hold on, you think I can do it?
Do you think I can finish my book today? Can you stop?
Sorry. Your phone's on random loudness.
Anyway, today is the day that we will finish this book if it kills me, and so that is today's plan.
Welcome, gang. Today, I'm wearing my red, white, and royal blue shirt. And my matching red, white, and royal blue earrings. So I'm very tired, but it's gonna be a good day.
Hello, I'm looking rough in the same clothes I wore yesterday, but I have graduation practice at 1. It is currently 7:54. I didn't finish my book last night. I went to bed instead, but I'm finishing this book before graduation practice. I don't care if it kills me. I don't care if I'm here in this lovely seat on my bed for the next 6 hours just writing until my fingers fall off. That's what I'm doing. So yeah, that's the plan. I've been listening to the Super Paper Mario soundtrack because that game is the best game ever known to man, but this is the one I've been listening to recently. Anyway, obviously as you can tell, I'm making this clip very long so I don't have to write, but after right now, so namaste. See you when I finish this book. Hello, gang. Life is crazy. So I just finished part two of my book, and all that's left is part three, and part three is super short, so I will be able to finish it today. But I was out sitting on the hammock procrastinating writing. My sister texted me. She's at the senior assembly. She's at school. I skipped the last day of school because I'm a loser and I wanted to finish Half Truths. So that's the title of my book, by the way, Half Truths. But she texts me and she says, you won an award. And I was like, ha ha ha, what award, for most days skipped? And she's like, no, you won like most likely to write a whole novel. And I was like, wait, that's crazy. Like, I wonder if anyone will like, I wonder if I'll have a chance to be like, hey, I actually skipped school today to finish my novel. I'm gonna post it on Snapchat once I like get the certificate and stuff and I actually like get my award. And when I go to graduation practice later today, I'll pick it up. But yes, I feel very, that's just so cool. I never thought that I'd like win an award. So I won an award for most likely to write a whole novel on the day that I'm trying to finish my book. So that's, the universe works in very weird and mysterious ways. And right now, all that matters is that I'm going to my grandma's house to go write outside and finish Half Truths because, oh, I'm so excited to finish it.
Hello. I'm at my dad's house. I'm never at my dad's house. This is really good. I don't know. Maybe I'll start coming more. But my sister, she says, okay, pick me up from school. I have a class at 10. I have to finish my essay. I have to do my experiment. It'll take 10 minutes. We come in. I start writing. You know, it's going to take 10 minutes. She does her experiment, writes me these notes, and says, will you help me write my essay? And I say, yes, of course, I'll help you write your essay. And she hands me this. This is how far she has on her essay. Oh my gosh, stop barking. It's just a light. Anyway, I have to write a whole essay for her so she'll pass her class. So do I get bonus sister points for this? I sure hope so. I would really like to get my book done before one, but that's not happening. So she is walking across the street to go get me a lemonade, and I am just, let's do this. We don't have much time, but let's write about some eggs.
Hello, this is our little setup at the moment. We have this Nightmare Before Christmas blanket, my novel, A Soda Shack, and we're just chilling on the grass. We're gonna finish this book today. It's gonna be awesome. I don't know if I can finish it in the next, like, I won't be able to finish it in the next hour before grad practice, but I'm finishing it today, and hopefully I'll finish it before, like, 5, and I'll be able to take it and, like, get it printed off and pick it up tomorrow. But, yeah, we're nearing the end of draft 0 or draft 1 of Half Truths, and I don't know if that's the real title. Okay, my camera cut out for some reason, but I don't know if this will be like the true title. I doubt it will be Half Truths, but that's what I've been calling it. So yes, Half Truths is currently at 85,059 words. I think there's about, I don't know, 4,000 words left, but we'll see what happens. It's very bittersweet to be finishing draft 1, but I'm just kind of rolling with the punches here because so much crazy stuff is happening. So I'm just trying to finish before tomorrow, before graduation. So yeah, I will let you know how everything goes, but right now we just got this little picnic area set up on my grandma's lawn, so I'm gonna go do some more writing and I'll catch up with you later.
I've been busy with graduation practice and stuff, but I came home to check my mail and I was expecting, I haven't unboxed it yet, but one of like a new book that I pre-ordered a couple months ago, but look what came. Oh my gosh, okay. I'm so excited. So I need to finish writing so I can finally dig into this because I'm so excited. Oh my goodness. I did not expect this to come yet. And I'm so excited to read this. Casey McQuiston, I love you. And it's here. I love it so much. I haven't even like read it, but oh, I'm so excited. The other bit of fun book mail I got was Hani and Ishu's Guide to Fake Dating. I have been anticipating this book for so long. I read The Henna Wars last summer. I listened to it on audiobook and I adored it. So this will be exciting, and so will this. It is 11 p.m. exactly. There's like a chapter and a half left, maybe 1,500 words left, and I cannot force myself to write it. But I am finishing this book tonight if it kills me, and so I think it might kill me, but there's a chapter and a half left, and I've been staring at my doc just forever, and I just can't write it. I just can't. My head hurts, and I cannot physically make myself write it, but I'm going to have to, because I will not be sleeping until I finish this, because I'm finishing it before my graduation, end of story, point blank period. I'm finishing it before 7:30 tomorrow morning when graduation practice is happening, so if I am up from now till 6:45, when I have to wake up for practice, that's how it's gonna be, because I'm finishing this book tonight, and that's what's happening. So, pray for me. I did it. I wrote the end. I really hate the last scene that I wrote, because I went into it not knowing how it's going to end. I have a better idea of it now, but in the rewrite, it will definitely change a lot because I kind of hate the ending. But at 87,866 words, the first draft of my book, Half Truths, is complete. And I'm feeling real good about it. Yeah, I really don't like the past couple scenes I've written, and they'll change a lot in, like, revisions. But we did it, and we're going to go print it off tomorrow. And I'm going to go to bed because it is 11:57, and I have to wake up for graduation practice at 6:45. So, yeah, I might film a little clip tomorrow, like, talking a little bit more about it. But for the most part, Half Truths is done with the first zero draft. It is absolute garbage. There's so much that needs to be changed and worked on, but we wrote a first draft. I've never written a complete full first draft, so yeah, that's, I'm tired and excited and just all the things, but mostly I'm just tired. So yeah, Half Truths first draft is done. There's so much work to do, but I'm so excited to do it. Hello and good morning, friends. My name is Abigail Brown. Welcome back to my channel. And today is going to be a very exciting day, leading up to very exciting weeks. But last night I finished my first draft of my book, Half Truths. It's garbage. There's so much that needs to be done. But today, not only am I going to graduate high school, I have all my cool stuff right there. I'm going to practice right now. But today I'm going to print out my first draft, or my zero draft. I wouldn't count it as a first draft because it is garbage. But yeah, I'm gonna go print out my manuscript today and graduate. So I will keep you updated, but those are our two big priorities for today. Print out my manuscript and graduate high school. Holy cow, I can't believe this is happening.